With the courtesy of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, this class is being taught to the 9th class students. Now I am going to start the first chapter, Our Earth. And this video is prepared by J. Venugopal, TGT, ABMS, Amrapuram. Let us know the objectives that you are going to learn in this chapter. The need to know about the Earth. Our universe, the sun and the earth. Earth as a planetary body. The evolution of the earth. Internal structure of the earth. Movements of the earth crust. And the earth's grid system. The earth is a blue planet in our solar system. We live on this earth along with millions of other animals, plants and microorganisms. Dear students, the earth is a storehouse of many resources. In order to make our life so comfortable, we exploit these resources without proper planning. Our reckless exploitation of the earth has resulted in the destruction of forests, rivers, hills, fellow animals, and even fellow humans. Generally, we call it as environmental crisis. And what the environmental crisis that we are facing today, do you know? Global warming, poisoning of our soils, water and air. Hence, it is the right time for us to build a new understanding of the earth, how it works and what we do on it and what we do with each other. If you observe the size of the earth from our universe, it is seen not rather than a tiny pixel. The entire human history has been done on this tiny pixel. Carl Sagan, a scientist, called it as pale blue dot. Now, let us understand the Earth as a planetary body. In our solar system, there are 8 planets. They are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. These planets rotate on their axis and also revolves around the sun. Every planet takes a certain period of time for completion of its rotation and also revolution. Observe the picture very carefully. In this picture, the earth rotates itself and at the same time it revolves around the sun. An imaginary line is drawn connecting North Pole and South Pole of the earth and it is called as axis. The path the earth revolves around the sun is called an orbit. Can you say what is the shape of the orbit? Yes, it is a circular shape. But how can you say? Can we prove it? While the earth revolves around the sun, the longest distance from the sun is 152 million kilometers. The closest point from the sun is 147 million kilometers. The difference between the two points is not so varied. That's why we can say that the orbit is in circular shape. The earth revolves around the sun at the speed of 107,200 kilometers per hour. It takes nearly 365 1/4 days for completion of one revolution. Generally, we call it as an year. Now, let us know about the evolution of the earth. Before going to it, let us know something about our universe. The universe started itself some 13.7 billion years ago with a big bang and that may end several billion years later. Observe the picture. There are many formed galaxies. In each galaxy, there are many formed solar systems. And within the formed solar systems, there are many planets and revolve around them. However, these astronomical changes take place over thousands and even millions of years. Very earlier, the people believed that the Earth was firm and stationary and the rest of the heavenly bodies are around the Earth, and this theory was called as geocentric theory. Just 500 years ago, it is proved that the Earth revolves around the Sun. Just 100 years ago, it was propounded about the origin of the stars, existence and disappearance in the universe. The Earth began to form about 4.5 billion years ago. The Earth has reached its present form through several phases. It began as a ball of swirling dust and clouds and passed through a molten stage. At that time, the Earth was very hot and was constantly bombarded by massive rocks and other materials from the space. In this way, the size of the Earth grew. The Earth was so hot that it was molten. But the lighter particles cool at the top and form a layer of crust. As the Earth's interior continued to cool, it contracted and the outer crust wrinkled, forming ridges. Gradually they became as mountains and basins, that means low areas, which became oceans later. After one half of the long span of Earth's history, the life appeared in the oceans. It slowly evolved into diverse plants and animals, including human beings, over millions of years. Now, let us know about internal structure of the Earth. The Earth has the radius with 6000 kilometers. We live on the outer layer of the Earth, that is called crust. This layer goes up to a depth of 3200 kilometers and it consists of various kinds of rocks. The middle layer is mantle. It is 100 to 2900 kilometers in thickness. The upper part of the mantle is a pliable layer over which the crust floats. This consists mainly of chemicals called silicates. The core is 2900 kilometers to 6376 kilometers in thickness. One sublayer is outer core. It has 2900 kilometers to 5100 kilometers in thickness and composed of liquid metallic minerals like nickel and iron. The other sublayer is the solid inner core. It has the thickness 5100 kilometers to 6376 kilometers of the Earth, is made up of iron compounds and heavy substances like gold. Now, let us go to know the movement of the Earth's crust. In the early 20th century, a German meteorologist and geophysicist, Alfred Wegener, introduced the theory of continental drift to describe and partially explain the present arrangement of continents and ocean basins. He postulated a massive supercontinent, which he called Pangaea. In Greek, the meaning is whole land, as having existed 220 million years ago and then breaking apart into several large sections. Wegener hypothesized that the supercontinent of Pangaea broke up to form, first one, Laurentia, at present North America, Greenland and all of Eurasia north of Indian subcontinent is located, and second one is Gondwanaland, at present South America, Africa, Madagascar, India, Arabia, Malaysia, East Indies, Australia and Antarctica is located. These two blocks were separated by a long shallow inland sea called the Tethys Sea. To bring a letter to your home by a postman, a certain address is required. In the same way, to locate a place, to know the climatical condition of a place, Earth grid system is very important. First, let us know about latitudes. The horizontal circle that goes around the Earth exactly in the middle, at equal distance from the north and south poles, is called the equator. It divides the Earth into two equal parts. This is the circle designated as 0 degree latitude. Latitude comes to us from the Latin word latitudo, meaning width. Latitude values range from 0 degree to 90 degree north and 90 degree south. The major latitudes are 0 degree equator, 23.5 degree north latitude, Tropic of Cancer, 66.5 degree north latitude, Arctic Circle, 90 degree north latitude, North Pole, 23.5 degree south latitude, Tropic of Capricorn, 66.5 degree south latitude, Antarctic Circle, 90 degree south latitude, South Pole. Counting from one pole to the other, there are 180 main latitudes. The word longitude derived from Latin word longitudo, meaning length. The longitude that passes through the astronomical observatory at Greenwich, England is called the 0 degree meridian, prime meridian or Greenwich meridian. There are 360 longitudes. We organize the main longitudes into two groups, 0 degree to 180 degree going east, which are the east longitudes, and 0 degree to 180 degree going west, which are the west longitudes. The longitude 180 degree directly opposite to 0 degree longitude is called the anti-meridian. So, there are 360 longitudes. Observe the world map. The day is different from one region to another region. It takes 4 minutes for the sun's position to move 1 degree of longitude. So, the sun takes 15 longitudes for completion of 1 hour. The world is divided into 24 time zones starting from the Greenwich meridian going east and west. When it is 12 pm on Monday at 0 degree longitude, it is 12 am at the anti-meridian. Just to the west of 180 degree, the Tuesday is just beginning, while to its east, Monday is just ending. Some countries would have more than one time zone with less than 1 hour division. For example, the time difference from the east end part of India to the west end part of India is 2 hours. This is considered too complicated to be useful. In such situations, some countries choose the time along one of the meridians that pass through their territory and follow the time of that meridian for the whole country. This time is called standard time. For India, it is Indian standard time. For Pakistan, it is Pakistan standard time, and so on. Some countries follow different time zones. For example, USA has 9 time zones, whereas Russia follows 11 time zones. My dear students, I think you have understood well this concept. For your more information, you may consult your teachers. Thank you very much for watching my video, and don't forget to like my video at the end.